Good evening, Neonates. JB Illusion here, back with singing adventures of Dawn, the megalomaniac Bruja, and her faithful child, Miss Heather, in the last willing installment. We went to LaCroix, and he said the enemy of my enemy is kind of my friend, even though I already made them my enemy. After we kind of spilled the beans about our run-in with Ming Zhao, he said, what are you talking about? Ming Zhao must have been behind this the entire time. We had no alliance. So... Nines is now cleared of charges. Go to the last round to talk to them. I mean, I am the prince and I was kind of in charge of it, but heaven forbid I go over there. I need to stay in my ivory tower to look at the Unkarn sarcophagus. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. Everything will be all right. Don't worry about it. You'll be able to go in to the last round and they won't hate you at all. You know. I hope they don't send your ashes back like the last guy. So, we've got Skelter to talk to, and we also have Damsel up at the top. I want to say, let's talk to Damsel? As opposed to Skelter, I feel like Skelter might hurt us. Actually, Damsel's 100% going to hurt us. Elysium, I'm guessing safe zone? Somebody in the comments down below, hit me up with that. I'm not familiar with that. I need to talk to Nines. The prince wants an alliance with the Anarchs. Cram it, where's Nines? I gotta talk to him about alliance with the prince. I mean, we could hit Damsel up with that same fire that she comes at with us. And you know what? Dawn's learned her lesson. Let's go with one. No. The blood hunt is off. Zhao killed Grouch. She's a shapeshifter. Settle down, Tartan Tiny. He called off the blood hunt. Zhao framed Nines. Let's go with one. I'm thinking Damsel kind of broke a little bit there. Although that's a fun image to think of. Seeing Ming Zhao getting bowled into a car compactor. Now you see why I want to talk to Nines? Where is he? Anyone ever tell you your buttons are easily pushed? Shh. Now, Nines? I love Damsel so much. I get it. Where's Nines? I need to see him tonight. Damsel, over here. Over here, Damsel. Calm down. Just tell me where Nines is. Alright, cool. Griffith Park? Thanks, Damsel. Did anybody else just hear something that sounded really ominous? Okay. Maybe we should get you something to eat, Heather. You sound a little famished. Should we talk to Skelter? Nothing, apparently. Alright, see ya. Where'd Jack go? I mean, Captain Corker, Sunny Boy. Okay. Oh, hi, Heather. Where the heck did Jack go? See, Jack knows some stuff is going down, so he peaced out. Okay. It's either... Like, well, Beckett peaced out. He's not feeling whatever's going down, so... Does that mean... He's feeling whatever? No, he wouldn't be feeling whatever Beckett's feeling because, you know, the whole thing with Beckett researching the Unkarn sarcophagus. He found out something that was wrong with it, something that was off. But where the heck did Jack go? Did Jack peace out sometime around the Sabbat attacking LaCroix? Us taking on the Sabbat? Where'd he go? I hope Ming Zhao didn't get to him. That would actually be a horrific fate. I love Jack, man. But then again, there's more to Jack than meets the eye. He's got to know something. Like, he knows something weird's going on. So, hold on. Do we need any type of guns or anything? We're kind of okay, and I stress kind of. We're not really... I mean, okay, we're fairly good. It's not like we're marching on Ming Zhao, so we should be alright. Alright, yo. Hop in. Sure, why not? Okay, let's go. Step on it to Griffith Park. Okay. So he managed to pick a fairly secluded area, I guess, away from normal kindred. I guess there's no, like, Nosferatu living out in Griffith Park. But, Jack disappearing bugs me out, y'all. Alright, Miss Heather, are you here? Good. Okay. For a second, I thought he ran over something, but we're good. I guess, so we have to take a thing up. Okay. I assumed that was just, you know, like a normal park. Where you just get in, walk around a little bit, have some fun. Sorry, Heather. But apparently we have to take this up. Alright, let's do it. Like, I'm getting some... Heather? Heather, could you please come with us? Oh, okay. Well, at least this is a nice view. This is pretty cool. So I guess Heather will stay behind and just check on some things for us. And we're headed on up. So I guess Nines has like a little shack up here somewhere? Away from where he knows the Camarilla don't really... Wow, that's a view. Hey, is that LaCroix's tower? Huh. Alright. Okay, so we're good up here. Let's get out. No Heather. Okay, she's just chilling out in the back then. Alright. Now let's see if we could find Nines. Nines. Hey, Nines. Was that a wolf? That kind of sounded like the same thing that we heard in the... In the city, right? So is it Beckett? A gangrel? Okay, well, we found Nines at least. I don't know if I like that howl. It's kind of bugging me out a little bit.
Good to see you again, kid. Heard you made quite a name for yourself. No small feat in this city. I hear LaCroix needs us all of a sudden. Well, I'll be damned.
Well, you kind of already are, but hey. He proposes an alliance with the Anarchs to get rid of the Kuei Jin.
Does he expect us to do all the fighting while the Camarilla throws mean looks from the sidelines? Or are they ready to go toe-to-toe with those goddamn devils?
That's actually a really good question, because from what I understand, Nine's sire was killed by the Kuei Jin, and I don't know, well, this was an Anarch state, I believe, sometime around that period. So I'm wondering, did the Camarilla just chill out and... watch from the sidelines, and then wait for the Anarchs to get weak enough to kind of move into the city? Or was there only a certain amount that was controlled by the Anarchs? That's actually really interesting, if anyone knows. Because I thought Cali for a while was an Anarch state. I think LaCroix is recent. So I think they might have just waited on the sidelines and then moved in, which I could understand would make Nines incredibly hesitant of doing this because the Camarilla might just sit on the sidelines and only do what is necessary for the Anarch's numbers to go down and then just kind of run everything. There'd be no real Anarch presence if they took the fight to the Kuei Jin and incurred mass casualties. Okay. They're willing to do anything it takes to make this alliance happen. They'll fight. The prince wants the Kuei Jin dead just as much as you. I don't know about that. Who knows what he's planning? That's not really good. We gotta sell him on this, right? They're willing to do anything it takes to make this alliance happen because LaCroix is getting desperate and he wants his sarcophagus. They'll fight the prince once the Quajin dead just as much as you. Are we gonna be honest and say who knows what he's planning? Who knows what he's planning?
I still don't trust LaCroix. But then again, the Camarilla didn't wholesale slaughter us upon arrival. God damn it. I'm stuck between a rock and a son of a bitch.
Okay, so yeah. So literally the Camarilla just chilled out, watched this fight go down, and then they walked into LA like, hey, we own it now. Do you have enough strength to fight us? No? Okay, well, you're still kindred, so we'll respect you and, you know, keep you on the sidelines for certain occasions. I'm ready to fight the Quajin. Your people need a leader right now, more than ever. But then again, the Anarchs don't have leaders. Let's go with two and see what happens.
It seems strange. LaCroix wanting to go to war against them all of a sudden. Something's not right.
I'll agree with that. But I think the alliance is for the best, because there's one thing that we can't really easily take on, and that's Ming Zhao, or whatever the heck she is. Kalyan told us, stay away from Ming Zhao, and I'm trusting our bestie Kalyan on that one. I agree we can't trust the prince. Were you scared to fight a few Quajin? I think the prince wants to protect, he's 100% about the Uncarnate Sarcophagus right now. I think the alliance is the best, because, look, you guys incurred heavy casualties when you fought the Quajin before, so if you could get Magilla Gorilla, the sheriff, to actually, you know, leave LaCroix's side to do something, it would be useful for you.
Not what I mean, kid. Smell that?
Huh?
It smells like smoke. We gotta get out of here.
Wait, what? Wait, so someone's trying to set us on fire in Griffith Park? Oh no.
We gotta get out of here. This is bad.
Wait, it's just a fire. We'll be fine. No, we won't. We will burn up. Big deal. It's pretty far off. Nothing to worry about.
No, kid. You don't understand. The fire wasn't set to kill us. Come on. We gotta get to the tram.
What do you mean? What are you talking about? What's the problem? If it wasn't set to kill us, then what was it supposed to do?
I didn't hide out here because it was a nice view. I did it because no one would come looking for me in these parts. This is werewolf country.
So, list of things you do not want to go on one-on-one in the world of darkness, I feel. A vampire who is a couple generations above you. You definitely don't want to go one-on-one with a werewolf. So what?
The wolves are going to be out for blood for that fire. Come on, move!
Okay, can't we tell them it wasn't us? We can take them? You scared of wolves?
Get to the tram. We can't waste any more time.
All right, I got your back. Don't worry, I got your back, man. What?
Come on, kid. We gotta get inside that building until it comes.
What? Oh, man. This isn't good. Please tell me that was the only wolf in the pack? Nope. Well then, it's time to run, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go! Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Wait, we have celerity. What am I thinking? Oh, okay. We're in a bad spot already. Celerity, here we go. Wait, that thing can catch up to us in celerity? Okay, it's time to run. Come on, Dawn. Close the door. Close the door. What? Okay, up we go. Okay, this way. Is there anything that we could do? Shoot. Okay, so that's not working. Is there any way that we... Ah, come on. Okay. I mean, celerity is doing wonders for us, but I think maybe I should stop it. Okay, so we haven't seen the werewolf yet. We could probably just hide out. Oh! What was that? Oh, hello, Mr. Werewolf. We're just going to go this way. Crap, 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 crap. Close the bathroom door. Wait, can we jump? No, we can't jump. Holy crap! Just when you thought you were safe. Just when you thought you were safe. Oh, yeah. Oh, dude, we're going back to the parking lot. Okay, so I guess it would be nice if there was an autosave right before a angry werewolf comes at you. So there's going to be a cut. And we're going to try to not get wrecked. Thanks for knowing better than us, Heather. Thanks for knowing that you shouldn't hop up there. Okay. Round two. Alright, time to run away from the werewolf. Oh, that hurt. Close the door. Close the door on him. Okay. We know we can't go that way, so let's try going this way. Okay. There has to be... Is there a way that we can get out of here? Okay, here we go. Ha-ha! Alright. Oh! Up here. Okay, where the heck is this? So this is an observatory, right? We can't open... We can't turn on the power. Also, we need blood heal, like, immediately. Okay, he's coming. Oh! Hello, sir! So we can turn on the power. Okay, perfect. Oh, we're dead. Okay. So... We're going to have to... Dawn is about as physically tough. Oh! Physically tough as a wet... Oh, he already broke through. Okay. Megan, possibly she. So... We're going to hit that celerity. And we're going to use our abilities... To our benefit, because Dawn is really as tough as a wet paper towel right now. It's not really that tough. So we can turn on. Okay, back in we go. Oh, hey, look. Well, the power's on. So what do we do? Hey, wait a second. I got an idea. Can we open this? Yes, we can. Okay. We just need Miss Werewolf, Mr. Werewolf to chase us, right? I hope this works. Mr. Werewolf! Where are you, Mr. Werewolf? Hello? I don't have an ingenious trap for you at all. Well, honestly, I'd rather shoot it, but... Didn't Nine say that guns really don't work against... wolves at all? I mean, we could try it. Oh! Where is he? I mean, we are literally fighting it in slow motion. I'm still afraid. Oh. Hey, Mr. Werewolf. Mr. Werewolf, where are you? Part of me wants to maybe give it a couple shots and see what'll happen. I mean, he's out there somewhere, right? Oh! Well, there he is. Ha! Sucks to be you, huh? It's dead, right? So it did work. It didn't seem like bullets were doing anything, but it was already in the animation. Okay. Can we open it up? No? Dawn can't collect its head? Okay. Whatever. It broke. Oh, wow. These things are deadly. That thing broke everything. I'm also glad we chose, you know, not to. Okay. So we need to stop and take a second to focus on this, right? So, one. Our boy, I am very impressed with Nines because he was hiding werewolf country, which is just ridiculous in and of itself. He's out here surrounded by nothing but werewolves by himself. It's a little scary. I mean, I feel like most kindred. I mean, LaCroix could not camp out here. Let's be real. Also, who knew that we were going to be out here? The only ones who knew that we were going to be out here were, what, the Anarchs and maybe LaCroix? Was there someone else who knew that the Anarchs were here, or were we tailed? Because the only people who knew that we were going to go see Nines at the last round was the Camarilla, the Prince, and the Sheriff. Those are the only two. Beckett wasn't in the room. Maybe Gary secretly was in the room. I don't know about that. But they're the only ones who knew. And then we go to the Anarchs. They have not snitched. But then when the Alliance was proposed to us, they're like, hey, okay, our boy is out at Griffith Park. They're the only ones who knew. I don't think the Anarchs would try to kill Nines because, I mean, technically there are no leaders in the Anarchs, but Nines is kind of someone that they respect and that they will follow. So that means LaCroix set us up. So think about it like this. If Nines died and he could blame it on Ming Zhao, like you've seen Damsel. Damsel's already ready to like rip somebody's throat out. So the Anarchs would go to full war against the Kuei Jin. Now, since we have made such good friends with so many kindred, they are 100%, you know, down for us. You know what I mean? We've made friends with quite a few groups, and knowing that we got taken out, they'd probably get upset, and that would lead to an interesting bit of warfare. I mean, there's a gargoyle that we have on our team, who I guess maybe is comparable to a werewolf. Not really the Camarilla's team. And there's a certain Tremere regent who would be very, very upset to know that it still lived. Okay. Well then, so I think we're good. So for future reference, anyone who is rocking out with us, tell Heather, I think if you tell Heather to just stay over here, this won't happen, but there were a couple problems going up the tram, I think is what it's called, mostly due to Heather trying to follow us. You know, if we go so far, Heather will vanish and appear right next to us. I think that was causing issues in the tram. It's a one-person tram, ladies and gentlemen. So just tell Heather to follow you, or maybe, you know, just stay in downtown, see what's up, make sure nobody's Okay, Jack? One, nice car. Two, what? We got some Elder Vitae, and we need to figure out what the heck is up with Jack, ladies and gentlemen. So I think we're going to save that for the next thrilling installment in the adventures of Dawn, the megalomaniac Bruja, and her faithful child, Miss Heather. Thank you all for watching. Please be excellent to each other and have a nice night. I'm still kind of trying to figure out who would know that we were going to be there. The only person I can think of is LaCroix, but then again, Jack showed up as well. Interesting, huh? Anyhow, good evening.